Among arthropods, breeding can sometimes be slow and sultry, other times fierce, frantic, and dangerous. The millipede seduction begins with a massage. With hundreds of legs, it's a full-bodied affair. These millipedes have 6-inch long bodies, but their sex organs are right at the front end, just 7 segments behind the head. All this caressing is to persuade the female to turn and face him. When she does, he passes a packet of sperm over to her. Millipede mating is a sedate, leisurely affair, often lasting several hours. For a male scarab beetle, it's a crowded scrum. This male on the right has found a female and clambers on her back. But he has a rival who uses his shovel-shaped head to try and pry him off her. But they're so busy fighting, the female's had enough and wanders off. A male scorpion has more to fear from a female than rejection. He grabs her and probes with his sting, confirming she's a female. But this potential mate could easily kill him, so he must grapple with her powerful claws to hold her at arm's length and keep his distance from her lethal stinger. Claws locked together, he leads her in a pirouette across the sand. This courtship dance signals his intentions and allows the male to search for a patch of solid ground on which to drop his packet of sperm. Here we'll do nicely. Hidden beneath his body, the sperm packet is smaller than a grain of rice. Having deposited it, he pulls the female around so she's directly over it. And she picks it up through a tiny opening at the base of her legs. Job done. A female mantis lacks the scorpion's stinger, but she too is a deadly predator. And she's just as happy to eat her partner. This male must approach her very carefully, so he doesn't become her next meal. Her abrupt warning display signals she's not in the right mood. If he doesn't back off, she'll kill him. Time to look elsewhere. This female might be a bit more amenable. As he inches closer, he releases a chemical signal to announce that he's a mate, not lunch. But the final approach is still a leap of faith. Lucky for him, she seems receptive. She holds still while he gets down to business. This female Honduran curly-haired tarantula with a leg span of nearly 6 inches is just as deadly. She spins a mat of silk, trip wires that detect any prey that ventures close to her lair, and she could easily kill this smaller male. but it's a risk he must take if he wants to sire the next generation. After nightfall, male tarantulas wander long distances in search of these femme fatale. Receptors in his legs tell him he's stumbled on the female's silken mat. And he quickly taps out a code on the silk to tell her he's come courting. But this is no romantic encounter. He must use his front legs to hold her half-inch deadly fangs at bay. While holding her aloft, he uses one of his palps to insert a sperm package into the female. Then he beats a hasty retreat, just in case she changes her mind. For many male arthropods, the mating game is a dangerous one. Yet the stakes couldn't be higher. Mealworms, originally from the Mediterranean, are now also global pests. But that's because they're so good at doing their job as nature's cleanup crew. Different teams of cleaners are called on for different jobs. In the rainforests of Malaysia, a jungle nymph gorges on a lovely fresh flower. But it's messy and squanders more than it eats. Below, the rainforest soil pulses as the cleanup crew rallies. In this case, Suriname cockroaches. They live buried in loose soil and begin to dismantle the wasted flower from below. Everyone hates roaches, but in the wild, they're actually the good guys, hard-working laborers on the cleanup crew. Many populations of Suriname roaches consist entirely of female clones that can reproduce asexually, so soon build up into huge numbers. All the better to get the job done quickly. Attracted by the scent, African flower beetles swarm over a piece of fallen fruit. They normally get their sugar fix from the sweet nectar in flowers, so this is a huge sugary jackpot. It pulls in a crowd. They slurp up the concentrated fruit juice and chew on the succulent flesh. But some recyclers have to take on less appetizing jobs. When a South American giant grasshopper molts, it discards its brittle exoskeleton. Not the most mouth-watering meal, but it still needs to get recycled. Arriving ready for work, woodlice. Woodlice normally recycle fragments of dead plants, which are made of tough cellulose. This exoskeleton is made of chitin, a similar carbohydrate, so a woodlouse's impressive digestive system can extract nutrients even from this dried-up husk. Without nature's cleanup crew, the world would quickly drown in rotting food, excrement, and corpses. This dead rodent is in need of disposal, and cockroaches are one of nature's undertakers. The putrid stink of rotting flesh is irresistible to these South American cave roaches. The roaches are so good at this job, they're one of the species of cockroaches being used to turn human food waste into compost, a process called blatty composting. But nature's cleanup crew has already made itself at home in our world, uninvited. Food like rice, pasta, cereals, is just dead plant matter to some bugs in need of recycling. Untidy pantries provide a feast for mealworms that, given the chance, infest our dried cereals and grains. When they become adult beetles, they mate right away. Each female can lay 500 eggs, a population explosion waiting to happen. That's not good news in our homes. This giant grasshopper delivers about 50 calories if consumed, which is why bugs have devised some remarkable ways to avoid being eaten. This giant spiny stick insect from New Guinea is aptly named. Long, sharp spines protrude from its back legs like daggers. These defensive weapons can inflict a very painful stab. So most predators leave the stick insect alone. These young South American giant grasshoppers don't seem to have any form of defense. So why do they hang around in large groups out in the open, sporting bright colors that make them stand out? Because these are no ordinary colors. Orange on black is nature's warning sign. I'm poisonous and taste foul. Leave me alone. And it works. If an inexperienced predator takes a bite of these guys, it won't make the same mistake twice. This caterpillar of the monarch butterfly sends the same message. It's packed with poisons stored from the milkweed plants that it eats. It's a universal signal to predators. Anything black and white with bright red, orange, or yellow is best avoided. Like this conspicuous Asian assassin bug. But this beastly bug is doubly equipped, carrying poison and a dagger. It has a very sharp hollow beak that injects toxins into its prey before sucking them dry. Wielding this hypodermic needle, it can defend itself against any predator that tries to eat it. And the toxins provide an excruciating bite. The nattily dressed tiger beetle lives in the same grasslands as the assassin bug and sports a very similar wardrobe, decked out in vivid black and white. But it's all a ruse. Tiger beetles are mimics. They fool predators into thinking they're poisonous. So for this tiger beetle, its biggest threat right now is another tiger beetle stealing its dinner. Warning colors are even more effective if they come with the element of surprise. The hind wings of this Peruvian stick insect are normally hidden. They're tiny, useless for flight, but create a bright flash of color that startles predators. Necrosia stick insects use a similar trick, but they can actually fly. The flash of shocking pink distracts predators while the insect gets out of dodge. A dead leaf mantis sits almost invisible in its disguise. But if it is discovered, plan B. It springs to life, flashing its dramatic eye spots, which must belong to a fearsome creature. It's enough to scare off most predators. Eye spots obviously work well. They're used by all sorts of bugs. This elephant hawk moth caterpillar has a tiny head and two pairs of giant false eyes on the fattest, juiciest part of its body. Moths and butterflies have turned fake eyes into an art form. They even have bright white catch lights, just like the reflections on real eyes. Being so small, bugs might seem easy prey, but they've found lots of ways to defend themselves, from poison to mimicry and bluff.